Okay, welcome back. We're looking at the economy. We'll be looking at the ministries, and we'll do this for this week. We're seeing how these ministries sort of interconnect with each other. And we're just looking at the economy. We then, before we went on break, we're looking at creating new jobs, which is going to be Dr. Chris Ngige's main function. And Sam, you were saying, well, he won't be doing it alone. There'll be interfaces with a lot of other ministries.
Definitely. But when you look at the man in that ministry, and you look at his antecedents, you will know that is somebody who can do that job, somebody who can really reach out. You remember Ngige, when he was, for the few months, he was governor of Anambra State. He moves around, he can reach out, he's humorous, and I think he will do the job. Definitely, it's not the Minister of Labour and Employment that will be creating job, but he will be tapping it from other ministries. Look at the new, look at the solid minerals, where we have Kaode Fayemi. Looking at the type of person Kaode Fayemi is somebody who will not accept failure. He will go all out. So,
But the man is a specialist in war studies, which connects to foreign affairs.
This is what I tell people.
Which is why some people thought they might have put him somewhere in foreign affairs.
No. This is what I tell people.
You disagree with such people.
When you are a graduate, first of all, you are a graduate because you can adapt.
Yes, intellectually. You have a certain intellectual base.
The man is intellectually, is of a high capacity of intellectualism. So, and I believe that he will never accept failure. So it's not Ngige himself, the ministry that will be creating employment, but will be interfacing.
Of course, okay.
With ministries and departments.
But we very soon, with joblessness, with people telling us that they took a degree 10 years ago, they haven't got a job now. These are some of the things that are going to
happen. People should not be expecting white collar jobs.
But okay, we're going to come back to that.
Yes.
I have a man on the line from Ikorodu. Mr. Idris, good morning, sir.
Well, yeah, good morning, Mr. Yori.
Oh, good morning. Okay, you're on.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yeah. This is my first time of calling him. So, well done, sir. You are doing a very nice job there, sir.
Very kind of you.
Sir, please, I want to commend the president for choosing the ministers he has chosen.
Okay.
For example, Babatunde Fashola, and many of them, Amechi, Chibuka Amechi of Transportation, and many of them. In fact,
you're happy with the entire list.
And I have no doubt, sir.
You're happy with the entire list, the way you're sounding.
Yeah, and I'm happy with all of them entirely because there are people who have been tested and they are, in fact, I can attest to the fact that people look at the road Fashola did in Lagos from my 12th to Ikorodu. I lived in Delta State for almost 20 years. I have not seen such kind of road in Delta State, even if that state is oil rich. The road that made it from my 12th to Ikorodu is, to me, the one of the best projects I've ever seen to compare to any other state. And he has done many of that road, many of that project in Lagos State. And for the 10-year duration, she has performed well in Ogun State. I think Ogun State is now the most industrial state now in Nigeria, if I'm not mistaken. And that also is also to be commended for that. And look at Amechi, he has performed well in River State. So these are the people that we know they have tried in Ngige, has tried in another state before he was removed by the court. He has tried and people love him there. So I commend the president for that and I love you people. May God bless you. Thank you very much for your program.
Thank you very much for calling in, Mr. Idris. Of course, we remember that it is Yemi Osinbajo, the vice president, that he will be coordinating, the economy, right? That's his constitutional.
The National Economic Council.
He chairs it. So he's going to be very, very conversant with what these people are, up to, not just the finance people, as you've just been explaining. It could even go to transport, it could go to every, quite frankly, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I was going to say, who isn't really concerned in the inquest, in this quest?
No, and you know another good thing about this team is that there is a nucleus of this Federal Reserve Council who have been involved even in the formation of the APC, in the development, of the manifesto. I'm talking of involved intellectually.
Yes, yes.
And that is,
and the roadmap especially.
And the roadmap. And that is why you find out that there seems to be a sync between the pronouncement of the president, the vice president, and other members of the government of Buhari on salient issues. For instance,
it would be a disaster if there was synchronization.
Big subsidy on petroleum product. There is a position on that. Look at the value of the naira. There is a position of that. The position may neither be right nor wrong. But one thing I know about having direction is that when you have a direction and there is unanimity of purpose, the chances of succeeding becomes very high.
Now, okay, Mr. Salau, Ikorodu, mm-hmm. Good morning, sir.
Hello, Ogaire, good morning. Good morning, Ogaire.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, Ogaire, I called last week. It was that call. I see, on this fashion of power, the cabal, the carpet baggers, the all just like power is just like all sector. So I don't know how this young man will destabilize these people so that we can, have life, because it's not easy. Okay, on Saturday I was given a bill of 10,000 naira to pay, and for the past 1 month I have not been getting light. So I don't know. Please, I don't know how you guys can reach this man, or let them come with a platform that we, if you have any complaint, to reach them, because this power issue, I don't know how you can handle it. Please.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for calling
me
in.
Let me respond.
Go ahead.
Let me respond to
okay.
You see, one good thing about these people that are running this country now is that they are accessible. On Facebook, I have link with virtually almost all of them. I remember I interact with the governor of Lagos State, Akinwumi Ambode. He replies, all of them. So this is our government. If you want them to succeed, you must be ready to contribute. For instance, I live in Ogijo. Before now, Ogijo to my 12. It used to take us about 3 hours, 3.5 hours. Yori, you cannot believe it this morning. I spent only 45 minutes because we interact. You interact, Nigerians need to interact Facebook.
What do you attribute that
to? On Facebook.
To? Attribute your 3 hour journey becoming 45 minutes. What? Better traffic governance?
Of course, control. By the state governor. Right now, they are working on this issue of power. I know that these ministers, they are in. And they hit the ground running. I'm sure right now, Babatunde Fashola is gathering data. We interact with them. No kaba.
Okay. There's a flow of communication wasn't possible in
before,
the past.
In this modern time.
Even presidents
apart
now.
Apart from that, the people involved, the ministers, they are accessible.
Okay.
You can interact with them. Then come into the economy.
One moment, please. Okay. I got to take Abdul Rahman calling in from where? Oh, Pangrove, not Ikorodu this time. Good morning, Mr. Abdul Rahman.
Very good morning.
Hello. You're on air now.
Okay, good morning, and good morning to the two wise men.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Video. Yeah, that's a very good work you guys are doing.
You're very kind.
My problem is this. I wonder how far this conversation can go. We've been talking, what in 1963 we've been talking and talking, but definitely there won't be change. But I pray that this president regime, I pray for good health, I pray for long life for them. They have no reason to fail. I strongly believe that.
All right.
You see, in fact, I wish I can express my joy through the phone, but God knows how happy I am. I just pray for good health for them. But my advice is this. I think it's time, just like how things have been done in other countries. It's not about talking on the radio or television, because some of those talk messages are the rest, or the people in China are not really be interested in watching some of our local stations. I think it's time we, the masses, also play a better role in assisting the government. We have to change our attitude. In some cases where some matters are being held down in the court, communicate nothing from us to go to the street and protest and demand for justice.
Yeah.
We must not just wait for the government or for the president alone to do everything. We cannot perform magic. If not, we come out in mass and protest for whatever we want. That's my point.
Thank you very much for calling in. You know, Yemi, earlier, I know you, Sam was speaking, but I got to come to you now. Earlier, we were talking about Mrs. Adeosun from Ogun State, now the Minister of Finance. Sam had mentioned her credentials as a public, you know,
a
public finance person. Interestingly, that's what Akinwumi Ambode also is. Akinwumi Ambode, you know, was a public finance person. Is there something about those guys that is like an added bit of extra?
No, it is critical. You see, if you take a typical business person who is very successful in business without a mindset, you know, for service, and you put him in the public sector, he is more likely going to be looking at the plus and minuses.
Okay.
Is tuned to profit. So it may not be tuned to service. It may not be tuned, you know, to service. And so it is an added advantage. This is not to suggest that entrepreneurs, businessmen cannot succeed in government.
Yes.
But when the moment they come to the public sector, it's a different ball game.
Okay.
You know, as a producer.
So public sector finance people have a different mental attitude to finance.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. They do.
Mm.
They do.
Mm.
And they understand that the customer they are dealing with now are not the same kind of person that the businessman, you know, deals with. So there must be a way to continue to meet, you know, their need.
And also get revenue.
And also get revenue from them.
Yes.
Because this time around, you know, in business, tangible goods or services are exchanged in hand. But in this case, you are not really selling anything to any citizen.
So it's a unique kind of expertise, really.
So it requires a different kind of mindset.
Mr. Adedeyi from calling in from Ikeja. Good morning, sir, and thank you for holding on.
Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to your guests in the house.
Morning.
Good morning.
I think the ministers already know what Nigerians are expecting from them. You know, because all along, since the inception of democracy, Nigeria has been unfortunate to have leaders who did not care for the citizenry.
Mm.
But now that we have a change, we expect them to start making that radical changes that will affect our lives. But what Nigerians should not expect is a miracle. Okay. Because I don't think any of these ministers are, you know, Angel Gabriel or Angel Michael that will now start throwing up magic wands. We should be patient with these ministers because things did not just go bad overnight. We have been having several years of, you know, economic degradation. We have been having corruption, endemic corruption. So to make changes, they will have to do quite a lot of work. So within months, we shouldn't start shouting and calling for their heads. Because I can tell you that some people are already waiting to start calling for the heads of these people in the next 2 months, hoping that they will have started working out miracles. They shouldn't be moved. This minister should not be moved. They should just concentrate on their jobs, make sure that they work things out. There are people that I know that are praying and fasting that this government will fail because they want it to be known that people made the wrong choice.
Yeah.
So this minister should be on their toes.
Okay,
work
then.
Very well. And don't be distracted by the comments of detractors.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning, and thank you very much, Mr. Adedeyi. But since APC won the election, one can then guess, you know, no more than guess that there will be a heck of a lot of people also praying that this government, you know, should succeed. Because the simple analogy is that if they won the election, there are more people that were for them than were against them, not to de-emphasize the opposition in any particular sort of way.
Yeah.
But, yes.
Talking about the economy again.
Yes.
You see, one thing this country has.
And I imagine a lot of what Mr. Adeyi was speaking about just now would have formed what they were speaking about at the retreat that they went to. You know, because he's saying that he just wants to caution Nigerians. We've been thirsty for a long, long time. But please, sorry.
Yeah.
It's not going to fix itself in two, three days.
Yes, that's true. Yes, having said that, I think one of the strengths of this country is our population, the market.
That's a strength.
But the largest market in Africa, sub-Sahara.
Mm-hmm.
In which China, Asia Tigers, even America, everybody is struggling to penetrate. So it's our market. Like he said, the government has taken the right position on the valuation of the Naira. The government has taken the right position of subsidy. You devalue your currency when you have you are exporting massively to make your goods cheaper at the international market, and you pump in volumes to rake in more revenue. But right now, the major foreign exchange and is still crude oil.
Yeah.
Whose price is not determined at home.
Mm.
So the government's position on those two issues are key. But that is not a static situation. By the time the economy is diversified, there is the need to encourage export.
Yeah.
We can come to that.
Yes.
Then on the issue of that market, on the issue of the size of our market, that on that issue, this government, they know that Nigerians are eager. They want, they need a change. They want to see a change. So the appointments in that case is another. And these people are already tested.
Okay.
But at the same time, all of us, we have to contribute one way or the other.
Okay. Mr. Lawale from Ikorodu, good morning, sir.
Oh, good morning, Uncle Yori.
Thank you for calling
God
in.
God bless you and the other panelists. Yeah.
Thank you.
Presently, we must give it to the president. He has chosen what I consider the best team for Nigeria. They are tested. There's no doubt about that. They have track record. Except some people want to deceive themselves. But we must give them ample opportunity to settle down. Study the situation. The rot of 16 years cannot be cleared in 6 months. Okay? So they should please be patient with the new team of Buhari.
Mm-hmm.
Buhari's track record himself, his integrity, his pedigree, will ensure that if 1 naira is voted for a project, let's say for construction of road, at least they will spend that 1 naira for that road. That I am clear about. So there will be no misappropriation of funds, or diversion of funds. God bless you.
Thank you very much for calling in, Mr. Olawale from Ikorodu. Our signal must be very good in Ikorodu because they call us from Ikorodu.
It's surprising. Perhaps I've influenced them positively.
Corruption, I don't know. If we can get corruption leaked in these key ministries, I imagine you sort of, it's like starving a fire of oxygen. Oh dear, why are you chuckling? Oh dear. Because I was looking that, look, if all these glory boys and girls, for instance, that we're talking about now, we place so much high hopes on them. And if we can therefore take for granted that because of who the president is and the president chose them, we can forget about that area. Therefore, below, in the not as juicy ministries, I'm wondering if my analogy of starving a fire of oxygen and therefore killing the fire can work.
Well, is it for me? I think we can comfortably assume that people will stay in line. I mean, the appointees of the president will stay in line.
Yeah.
But one thing is also certain: if they choose, and when they choose to fall out of line, the big man will wield the big stick. Don't forget, it's easy to sack a minister. You don't need to go to the Senate to get any resolution.
Mm.
So one thing that is certain with me, for me, is that the president will not condone any of this happening under any of these people. And don't also forget that the party in power in government now, APC, wrote to government on the crest of anti-corruption, the economy, and insecurity.
Yes.
So they just have no choice other to ensure that they secure, you know, their place in government by upholding all of these tenets.
Okay, we got a call from Auchi Edo State, Mr. Abdul Rashid. Good morning, sir.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I'm calling from Ikeja.
Okay. Oh.
So where did the Edo State, Auchi Edo State come from? Please go ahead. Are you Mr. Abdul Rashid?
No, I'm not. I'm Mr. Cosmas.
Cosmas? Did you say Cosmas? Why did they cut him off? They did, but because I think they mixed it up and unfortunately went and cut him off instead of letting him just continue with the correct name. Very, very sorry, whoever you are, sir, that I miss, sorry.
Let me quickly say this before we finish. Somebody spoke about the cabal in power and in petroleum and the rest of it. Sincerely speaking, all we just need is thinking out of the box.
Okay.
Now,
apparently, that's not a very easy thing to do.
And it is not a very,
easy thing to do. It means you must be adventurous.
But when you have found people who have shown capacity, no matter at the level they have done it, there is a chance that they can, repeat it at, the higher level. Nobody, you see, we have a very short memory as human beings. Nobody will tell. Nobody can get rid of Oshodi.
Okay.
Despite many years of military.
That is the chaotic situation in that area called Oshodi, where traffic is upside down.
You deployed police, you deployed the military, you deployed everybody, yet you never got rid of it. But it took a civilian governor to permanently
fix Oshodi so that traffic is flowing relatively easier now.
All you need to do is to let people know that if we move from here to that place, point, all of us will benefit from it. And there are ways of doing that.
And I think the people are ready to be led. The thing with the people being ready to be led is that this time everybody is shining their eyes. And so in as long as they consider that you're still on the right track, they will follow. I guess the trick is going to be persuading people that we are on the right track, because oftentimes those tracks are not the most comfortable to walk on.
You are right. I think APC coming to power is three major reasons: the security issue, the economy, and
anti-corruption.
So that success should be guided jealously to the extent that anything corruption should be fought
with
the last teeth. If you want to bite it,
and the president has helped a bit. He has helped a bit by announcing that he's the Minister of Petroleum himself.
Of course.
So that one, you know where it is.
Yes.
You know where it is.
So in this issue, there will be cabals will be useless once our refineries are working. Once we have modular refineries in place, not only one, not only two, not three, have enough refineries. We have this crude. It's at home. I don't believe, and I've always been saying it. What is subsidy? Subsidy is when somebody else is paying for what we are consuming, which we don't have.
Mm-hmm.
But we have crude.
Okay.
So once we fix the refineries, we have enough. Once the economy is working, we have enough. Cabal will be cut off.
I think we can go to Auchi now, Edo State, and Mr. Abdul Rashid. Good morning, sir.
Yes, I will see you. Good morning.
Good morning. Please go ahead. I won't interrupt you anymore because of the feedback.
Okay, good morning. My name is Abdul Rashid, speaking from Auchi. Okay.
Don't listen to yourself. Just continue.
In respect of the new minister. So I want you, okay. I want you to know that the work of this minister is a work of which all of Nigeria know that they will do better with us. Because what our SNS doing, he knows that he will do well. Because we say change. I know to make change is not what is easy. And I want all Nigeria to know that, because I want to make a reference to our governor, the Adaso Somori. Because when he started for Edo State, everybody was thinking that the man is done nothing. End of the day, he purified Edo State. That we all believe that our excellency Buhari will do more than. So the Nigeria will take a lesson that it will be good to be good. Because a good name a good sworn. So I believe, especially our excellency, the governor of Lagos, former governor of Lagos State,
and the other ones, and former governor of Anambra, Igege, with the people that we can account for, and I believe they will do more to see Nigeria to know that it is good, to be good. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Abdul Rashid. You're our last caller today. We've run out of time, in fact. But doing this sketch, as it were, this sketch conversation on the new new administration and the ministries and their distribution, it looks like all those guys, the work is cut out for them. But happily, most of them are willing alcoholics, you know, even from before. I don't know, Fashola, for his own part, I don't know how many days of how many hours of sleep he was getting. So nothing new.
Developed gray hair.
I've seen jokes that now he's going to have a completely white head of hair.
Golden.
I've seen those jokes. The finance minister, she comes, you know, highly rated, you know, knowledgeable in public finance. All sorts of people are going to be connected. This is a conversation that we're going to continue till the end of the week. And of course, we're looking to get those ministers to come in here and tell us what their plans are. You know, there's nothing like hearing it from the horse's mouth, or in this case, the minister's mouth.
I think in closing, I should just say this. A lot of people have asked for patience. Yes, it is important. But for those in authority at this point, they must know that three things are required: courage, redefinition of the problem, and a sense of urgency. And once they are seen to be pursuing all of that, the people will show understanding.
Well, I'm going to have to leave it there.
In closing, I wish them good luck. Not Jonathan, but really good luck, because the challenges ahead is very, very high. I don't envy them, but I know they will perform.
Thank you very much, Sam Olisa, economist and financial analyst, and Yemi Mapadero, strategy and governance consultant. Thank you, gentlemen, for sharing your insights with us. I'll see you tomorrow with a fresh edition. I'm Yori Folarin. Bye-bye for now.